UNICEF just did a study showing that 54% of parents, when their child does something wrong, they immediately scream or yell at their child. And that worries us a lot, because the latest research on brain development shows that when you scream repeatedly at your child, actually it has an impact on the brain development and on the emotional development of that child. And we have studies showing that children become more fearful, sometimes have violent behaviors, they have difficulties focusing at school, they have difficulties making friends. And later in life, the impact on their health is actually tremendous. So we see violence against children being associated later on with problems like obesity, smoking, drinking, heart diseases, taking drugs, etc. We decided to focus on verbal violence because this is the most invisible form of violence against children. It's the most accepted in Romania, as in many other countries. What we do at the local level is we work with local professionals. So we work with social workers, we work with community nurses and other local professionals to sensitize them to violence. Because there is a high tolerance in Romania towards violence against children, because people accept it, these professionals are part of society. So they don't always identify the forms of violence against children. So the first step is to also raise their awareness so they understand that a child who is yelled at or humiliated by parents or threatened by parents is a child who is a victim of violence. So they need to identify the case. And then we develop tools to help them address the situation. How do you work with parents? It's not a question of punishing parents. It's the question of increasing the capacity of parents to educate their children without violence, with positive reinforcement, with constructive methods. We know that almost all parents, they love their children and they want the best for them. Because they were raised in a certain way, they replicate that behavior with their own children, thinking it's the best way to do it. So our message to parents is, violence is not necessary to raise a child. Actually, violence is detrimental to children. If you want to raise a child who is happy, who is balanced, who thrives at school, who later on will become a productive citizen, a happy father or a happy mother, you need to learn new tools, new ways to interact with your child, based on positive reinforcement, constructive feedback, etc. It does not mean that you are weak. It means you are a strong parent who is able to raise a happy child.